Yeah, Lord. All right. Yes, sir. There is the prayer of the petition.
Yes, sir.
There is the pressure on the petition.
Yes.
There's the power for the petitioner.
Yes.
There's also the persistence of the petitioner.
All right.
For the text tells us that he went three times and prayed to the Father. And if Jesus prayed three times, he didn't give up because of the fact that he knows that he's setting an example for us. He wants us to understand that we are not to give up. When things look difficult in our lives, when they look insurmountable in our lives, when it looks like things are impossible, don't give up, but just keep on praying and hang on in there. Because that which is impossible to man is possible with the God we serve. For the God I serve makes all things possible. For I read in his word where it says, I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me, which tells me that eye has not seen, ear has not heard, and neither has it entered into the heart of me, the good things that God has in store for them that love him. And if you love the Lord, and if you just keep on pursuing, God will bless you, and you will see his blessing manifest in your life. Well, there's the prayer of the petition. There's the pressure on the petition. There's the power for the petitioner. There's the persistence of the petitioner. Well, as I look at this text, I also see there's the pleasure of the petition. When I look at this text, Jesus says, not my will, but thy will be done. And Jesus wants us to know that he did not come to be served, but he came to serve. And it was his pleasure to do the will of his Father. And since it is his Father's will, that he goes to Calvary, and that he dies on Calvary's cross. And Jesus' pleasure was always to please his Father. And if it pleased his Father for him to go to Calvary, Jesus is willing to go to Calvary's cross, even though it meant separation from his Father, because it meant death on Calvary's cross. Here Jesus is now out of eternity and in time. For into eternity past, he had never been separated from his Father. But here he is now in time, facing separation from his Father. He really says, well, Father, if it's your will that I be separated from you, I will go ahead and go through with it. And I will go to Calvary's cross because I want your will to be done. Well, not only is it the pleasure of the petition, but it's also the promise to the petitioner. And when I look at the promise to the petitioner, the promise said that if you destroy this temple, in 3 days I'll raise it up again. So he has the promise and the assurance of knowing that death will only be for a short time. That's why when I observe what happens on Obedient Thursday, once I look at the agony of obedience, then I can really and truly celebrate what happens on Palm Sunday. Because now Palm Sunday is really triumphant in my life. When I look at what happens on Obedient Thursday, I can truly celebrate what happens on Friday. Now Friday is really a good Friday. Because if Jesus hadn't been obedient in the garden, Friday would not have happened. But because Friday did happen, and because he died on an old rugged cross, because he hung there from the 6th to the 9th hour, and he said, it is finished. And the it that was finished was the plan of salvation. And I'm glad he said it is finished. And he did not say I am finished, because he was not finished. For the record is that he committed his spirit into his Father's hand. And he died on Calvary's cross. He hung his head in the locks of his shoulder. And he gave up the ghost. And he died on Calvary's cross. He died until heaven was satisfied. After dying on Calvary's cross, they took him down and they buried him in Joseph's new tomb. When I looked at that, I wondered why he had to be buried in Joseph's tomb. Looked like to me the maker and creator of all things could have his own tomb. But they buried him in Joseph's borrowed tomb. Well, I discovered why he borrowed a tomb. When I looked back over Jesus' life, I discovered that Jesus was a borrower. Even though he made and owned everything, he didn't own nothing while he was down there. For the record is, he borrowed a body to come to him. After borrowing a body to come to him, he borrowed a manger to be born in. After borrowing a manger to be born in, when he got to the age of 30 years old, the record is that he borrowed a boat to go preach.
Over in that that there's someone here today who needs Jesus, we extend him to you today.
Hallelujah.
Hand it for baptism, let her even on your Christian experience. And if you're here today, we ask you to come. Come accept Christ as your Lord and Savior. Understand that we've all sinned and come short of the glory of God. And even while we were yet sinners, Christ died for you and me. And so if you're here today and you believe that, the Bible says all you have to do is believe in your heart that God has raised Jesus from the dead. The Bible says thou shalt be saved. Is there one today who has accepted Christ but has yet to unite with the local church? If you're here today, we extend this local church to you today. Is there one today? Is there one today who's out of the ark of safety? If we extend Jesus to you today, is there one? Are you here today? The Spirit's talking to you after a powerful message like that. Are you here today? Accept Christ. Amen. There's another category. Restoration. You've been out of fellowship with Pleasant Green for more than 3 consecutive months. You're here today. We ask you to reunite. Restore your membership today. Is there one today that needs to restore their membership today here in Pleasant Green? We extend to you today. We don't ask any questions. Just come where you can be fed through the Word of God. Is there one today?